I always wonder if you guys really want to see all of these empties or not, but I know that many of you like to see these because they are the videos that show you what we've used up. And then there are also the videos that I show you what I will repurchase and what I will be skipping over. And that's kind of a good thing because once you use something up all the way, you definitely know whether or not you're going to repurchase it. So this video I titled the way I did because my good friend Sherry from Graceful Beauty titled hers that way. And when she had the 55 empties up on her screen, that was like super intriguing to me that you could go through 55 products. So mine isn't quite 55, it's 32, but we're pretty dang close. Okay, and just really quickly for you, the necklace and the earrings I've had for about 6 or 8 years, something like that. The shirt I can link on Amazon. Isn't it cool? It's so cute with its side. It goes all the way down the sleeve. It's so cute. So I will link the shirt for you guys. And as always, the makeup that I'm wearing. So I'll make sure that I link that for you guys as well down below. So enough jibber jabber. We're going to get on with the video and we're going to go fairly quickly. I am not going in any specific order. I think I have about 32 products in here. I want to go fairly fast through them if I can because there's a lot. So let's get into my product empties right now. All right, during the holidays, Ulta had on sale their different candles and they came in these huge ones and I think that they were 2 for $25 and then I had my 20% off coupon. This one is gingerbread latte. And it had a wonderful gingerbread smell to it. Not too spicy, although I did get a spice one from them that I liked a lot too. But this one was more along the lines of just like a soft ginger smell, which I really like. So they last a long time and the scent was really good. I did get another candle just from, I think this was from TJ Maxx. And I loved the bottle on it, obviously, because it's purple, but it didn't burn real well. It burnt, you know, the opening right here. And then a lot of the wax is still left in there because the wicks went down before the wax did. So the delivery system wasn't great. I probably won't buy this design again, even though it's got a lot of intricate on here. I might clean this out and use it just for a bottle in my bathroom or something. I thought the bottle was really pretty. And then this is the Stimulating Shampoo by, oh gosh, this is Revita. This I bought when my hair started to fall out so bad and I wanted to stimulate growth. So this one says it's re-densifying, anti-thinning, and fortifying. These shampoos usually have the DHT blockers in them that they stop the hormone from making the follicle fall out sooner than it's supposed to. This one did really good. My hair is doing really good now. It's making a good recovery even though I lost over half the volume of it. So it's doing really well. I actually have a billion little teeny tiny hairs, which I actually attribute to another empty in here along with this, which is my minoxidil. Now this is one that you have to use indefinitely. But you know what, you guys? I do skincare every night and this is really inexpensive. I get a 3-pack of them. They last me about 4 to 5 months, depending on how much you put. You're only supposed to put one dropper. And the other thing is that the three of them are only right around $15, $16. So I feel like this is a really good investment for me with my hair. And this one was a little bit more expensive. I'm probably not going to buy this. I did find another one. I'm hoping that it gives me as good as benefits as this one did because the benefits of it were really good. It just wasn't super cost effective for me. Also for my hair, I bought during the holidays a bunch of these little travel sizes of different dry shampoos because I wanted to try them out. It was the Sephora favorites. And this is the SGX NYC. And this one is the Do It All 3-in-1 Dry Texture Spray. And it's supposed to have a hairspray in with the dry shampoo. And I don't think I'll be repurchasing a big one of these. I didn't really like the consistency of it. I didn't really feel like it did much of anything. As a matter of fact, as I'm putting it on, usually with dry shampoo, you have to kind of work it into your roots. And this one, I didn't feel like there was anything there. It almost felt like air going on my hair. And I don't feel like it gave me a better longevity either as far as keeping my hair, you know, the dry shampoo you use to keep your hair's oil at bay. So I don't really feel like it did that good of a job. So I probably am not going to be repurchasing that one. Another thing that I'm probably not going to be repurchasing is called the Unwash Hydrating Mask. This is the, I think it's from the New Clean. This is one that I specifically didn't want to repurchase just because I didn't feel like it got my hair clean enough. You know, this is kind of all the rage now where you just use those conditioners to clean your hair instead of, you know, using any sort of a shampoo or anything like that. And a lot of them just don't work for me because my hair is so fine. They end up weighing my hair down. So this is one that I got. I don't remember where I got it from, but I probably won't be repurchasing it either. But something that I will be repurchasing is it's a 10 Miracle Leave-In plus keratin. Keratin is the building block of our hair anyway. So keratin is really good and it also fortifies. And I really like it's a 10. I love the lightness of this. It does 10 different things. It's supposed to do detangle, condition, smooth, shine. I don't know. It's supposed to do a ton of things. So this one also has keratin in it, which is supposed to also leave your hair stronger. So I really did appreciate this one and like it. It is a couple dollars more than the original one, but it didn't matter to me. I kind of think I got this on a buy one, get one half off. So I really love this product and will be repurchasing that one again when I can find a sale. And then the best thing that I found for my hair this time of empties is actually cut in two in this one. So I got my new one out. This is from Pravana. This is the Perfect Blonde Purple Toning Mask. Okay, so this is supposed to have the properties. You'll probably be able to see it better over here. So it's supposed to have the properties of being able to tone your hair and give you a little bit of conditioning. I don't find that the conditioning is that great on it, but boy, howdy. The purple on it is so deep and it has helped my hair so much. And a lot of you have asked if I've gotten my hair colored recently. Well, I've been using the same color, but I've been turning it into a little bit ashier color with this purple toning mask. And it's not that expensive and I use quite a bit on my hair because as you can see, I have a lot of hair. So the way that I have been using it, besides using it in the shower when I do wash my hair, I've been setting aside a specific day when I bathe at night, but in the morning I'll get up and I'll wash my hair and I will go ahead and towel it dry and put this on and let it sit on for like 15 minutes and then go in and just do a final rinse of it again. And oh my word, you guys, it takes out any brassiness whatsoever of my hair. And I'm so glad that I found this. You can get it on Amazon, fairly inexpensive, and you can get it on walmart.com, even a little bit more expensive. So I'll make sure that I list both of those for you. It's a really good product. All right, so I always have to chuckle when I show you guys my Retin-A. I take these tubes and I just squeeze them down to the very last bit. This is my last one of the 0.05 of the Tretinoin that I got. I think I bought these from reliablerxpharmacy.com. And you can get Retin-A or Tretinoin in the 0.1% from there, but you can only get it in the gel and it's way too harsh for my skin. So I was watching Jennifer Joy's Beauty and she had from another source, which I will make sure that I link below, about the Tretinoin in the 0.1% that is actually the lotion. So she saved us all. And I actually think it was from one of her viewers that did it. So I'm going to definitely make sure that I list all of that below if you're interested in the highest strength that I've seen so far. I know that there are higher strengths than that, but so far I am okay with it. I'm at the 1 week. I'm only using it once a week because my skin is a little bit sensitive right now. So I'm only using it once a week and I'm using it on top of moisturizer. So, and that's how I always use my Retin-A anyway. I don't know if you guys want a whole new video on Retin-A and what I do with it or not. Let me know in the comment section and I'll be happy to do that for you. So I used up so much skincare besides the Retin-A. The first thing is from Hylamide. Hylamide is a sister company of The Ordinary that is sold on DCM.com. And this is the high efficiency face cleanser. And I really love this product. The second time I've purchased it, I love it for taking off all of my waterproof eye makeup. I really like it a lot. Right now I'm using the Good Molecules Balm and I like that too, but I think this did a little bit better job at just emulsifying everything that was waterproof so it came off without damaging my eyelashes. So I do like balms. I think they're great. I think they have their purpose, especially, you know, when you want to take off all of your other makeup. But for me, this one is really good and yes, I will repurchase it. Also from Good Molecules, I went through a super peptide serum am liking this very much. I'm not sure which I like better, whether I like the Ordinary's Buffet or whether I like the Super Peptide Serum. I do have two more of these that I'm gonna go through and use, and I will know by then which one I like because I've been using the Buffet for years, but this one's really good. It doesn't ball up, it plays well under makeup. I use it morning and night. There's no irritation with it, adding it to my routine or anything like that. So have been enjoying that one a lot. And then this one I got sent to me from Dr. Lily Fan. Yes, that's her name. This is the Probiotic Recovery Cream Anti-Aging Moisturizer, Anti-Aging Restoration Moisturizer. So I went through this. It's got a really nice delivery system. This was sent to me in PR, by the way. Now, I liked this cream itself, but I don't know if I would repurchase it just simply because I didn't see that many benefits to it. It wasn't super hydrating. I didn't see any anti-aging benefits to it. So it's probably not one that I would repurchase in the future. Also from Australian Gold, this is the Mineral Lotion Non-Greasy Botanical 50 SPF Broad Spectrum. And this is the sunscreen. It says for face, and this is tinted. And it says it's antioxidant rich. And I do like this because it is a natural product and it's a mineral product. I did like it. However, I didn't like it under makeup. It just seemed a little bit too heavy for me under my makeup. And so I was using this, you know, like on my chest and my neck and my arms and hands and stuff. So I love the way that it made everything look. And, you know, on days when you just don't want, you know, a lot of makeup, it would be great to just put this on and have it. I love this. I would recommend it for anybody that has dry skin. You might need to just try it out. It's not very expensive. So maybe just try it out and see how it works for you. Also from Hada Labo. And Hada Labo is a Japanese skincare company. I love a lot of their products. This was a milky essence and it was a brightening one. And I really, really liked using this one. I went through the entire bottle, probably took me maybe 6 months, somewhere in that area, to go completely through it. But I did notice a lot of more evenness on my skin, and it did help a lot with my red blotchy patches that I have on my cheeks. And so I probably will repurchase this. I'm right now going through their premium hyaluronic lotion, which is really nice too. So I'm just kind of exploring Hada Labo and what I think of it, but this is one that I would recommend and that I would repurchase. And then from Suko Yakusuhara, you guys know how much I love this line. So much so that again, I cut the tube in two and I get every last drop out of it. I absolutely love this cream for my eyes. I use it morning and night. It plumps so well. I originally heard about these products from my friend Penny at Penn.Smith.Skincare, including the Hada Labo one, by the way, and another one I'm going to show you. She has the best recommendations. I will make sure I list her below if you guys haven't seen her. She's just fantastic about skincare. But what is really great about urea, and no, this is not, you know, urine product at all. It is not based off of that. It's created in a lab to mimic those properties. And so urea is a byproduct of urine, but it's not in here. And I say that every time because I get somebody asking me that almost every time. Love this eye cream because you get such a soothing benefit from it. And my eyes have become sometimes so dry in this climate and so irritated, and this just soothes them and makes them calm down. And by the morning, I can still feel that I have a little bit of that hydration on there. But what else is really great is urea has a property of being able to exfoliate a tiny bit. And what's so good about that is being able to put it up underneath your eyes and on your eyelids. There's nothing that we can exfoliate with that they want us to get around our eyes because it's just too dang harsh. And urea's not. So I think that that is just a really great property of it. And then I also use the really thick cream that comes in this jar. This is probably my fourth one of these. And the reason that I use this one is I put all of my skincare on at night. And if I don't use it, I wake up in the morning feeling dry. I have dry heat come from the ceiling. It's very dry climate where I live, like 10% humidity or less all the time. And in the winter, it's even worse. It's probably like negative percent humidity here. But even if I use a humidifier, I still like to use this because I really love that it just locks in all of my skincare and gives me that super dose of hydrating moisture. And I also put this up underneath my eyes at night in order to give them extra moisture at night. Love these products. They are some of my very, very favorites. I have never tried anything that has been as good as the Suko Yakusuhara. So those are ones that I highly recommend. From Thank You Farmer, this is the Miracle Age Repair Toner says for all skin types, and it's anti-aging, and it's a big bottle, and it took me quite a long time to go through this bottle. The only thing that I will say is if any of you gals are sensitive to fragrance, this one has a strong fragrance, so please be careful if you get it. Now, I did use it up. I did only get about halfway through, and then I decided to switch it to my arms because my skin was getting so sensitive with the dryness. So I really have noticed that my arms really loved it. It was just a beautiful product on my arms and really has helped lighten my arms. I feel like it's done a really good anti-aging benefits there. So I would use this more as my serum before my moisturizer on my arms and my hands. So I do love it. It works really good on my face. I just got a little bit sensitive and was worried that the fragrance would be too much for my face. I used up a sample or a trial size or a travel size of the Genifique. This is the actual lotion from Lancome. And I had their serum and this one, and I had two samples of each. And actually, you guys, it didn't feel like this did anything better for me than my skincare that I get off of Amazon that is so much less expensive. So even though I think it's a beautiful product, I think the ingredients are great, I don't think that this is a product that I'm going to say, oh yeah, run out and get it, because the price point is so, so high. I do love some of their products from the Genifique line, but as far as the youth serum and this particular one, I don't feel like it was the be all and the end all of the anti-aging world. And so it's not something that I'm gonna say run out and get, and I'm definitely not going to repurchase it because I found some things that are just as good and they have pretty much the same ingredients and you can get the same benefits from them, even though it is a good product. All right, if you guys haven't tried Lumify, I can highly recommend this because I actually use this every single time that I'm gonna film or that I'm gonna go out or anything. I wear contacts, so it is safe for contacts. They tell you that you just have to wait 15 to 20 minutes before you put them in. So I'll put them in right as I get out of bed, do a few other things, brush my teeth, wash my face, that kind of stuff. And then I'll go put my contacts in. I haven't had any problems whatsoever with it. I really like them. It makes your eyes just look so bright and so pretty. So I love that. I continue to repurchase it. From The Ordinary is the Moroccan Argan Oil. This is the Argan Oil that is in the Josie Maran Argan Oil line. And this is just a fraction of the cost. I think this is under $8. I think something like that. But I love this stuff. I will use this everywhere, you guys. I will do cuticle massages with them. I'll put it on the back of my hands before bed. I'll put it drops of it underneath my eyes, on the ends of my hair. It just is an all-around fantastic oil on my feet, my heels that get cracked sometimes. It's such a good oil for everything, and it just seems to just really sink into the hair and really give the hair a really good treatment. I just really love how this brings my hair back to life, and the next day it just seems to have a lot of shine and a super lot of softness. So I'm in love with that, and that's, I've repurchased that a million times too. I have a lot of setting sprays for you guys this time. This is from Wet n Wild. This is the Natural Finish Setting Spray. This one is from NYX. This is the Radiant Finish Spray. And this is from CoverFX, the Illuminating Setting Spray. I really liked all of these, actually. The Natural Finish one, I would say that that one is probably the most drying out of all of these. These two didn't seem to be drying at all, the Radiant Finish or the CoverFX. I know that the CoverFX is a little bit more. It took me a long time to go through this bottle, it seems like, because it had the properties. There is a little ball in here, you guys can kind of hear that shakes up the product. So there are those little particles in there that need to be mixed up really good before you spray your face. But it gives just the most beautiful natural sheen to the face. It's a gorgeous glow that it gives you. And so that one is really nice, but again, the price of it. And I like the L'Oreal one just as good for that one. And this Radiant one is almost as good, I would say. It's probably like 80% as good as this one from CoverFX. And then of course the Wet n Wild Natural Finish. I just use that as a setting spray, not as a finishing spray. And then I also have quite a few mascaras that I went through. These two mascaras were in my mascara video where I showed you mascaras that I absolutely loved. The Falsies Lash Lift from Maybelline. Love it. It feel like it holds the curl, gives me lift, gives me volume. But my favorite one is the Lash Princess Waterproof. Now, I didn't have a lot of really good luck with the other Lash Princess ones, the green tube and the other colors. But this one, because it is the waterproof, it doesn't act like waterproof. What it acts like to me is smudge proof. So I get the volume, the length, and the curl hold because of the waterproof properties in it, but I don't feel like I have to take it off with, you know, a ton of rubbing or working at it at all. It just seems to come off really a lot easier than a lot of waterproof products or waterproof mascaras that I've used. So I can recommend both of those. They went on to my favorites at the drugstore. And then for my bottom lashes, I almost every single day, unless I'm trying out something that's waterproof, that's new to me, I will put on the Benefit They're Real on my bottom lashes. And I love this stuff because it never, ever smudges, flakes. It never does anything, never leaves anything on there. And at night, it comes off fairly easily, but it is a little bit more pricey. So I have a tendency, you know, you're supposed to only have them open for 3 months. I have a tendency to keep mine for about 4 because I'm only using it on my bottom lashes. And then if there's a mascara that I'm finding that is too flaky, but I enjoy the formula, I can put this on as a top coat on top of it and it locks it in and I'm not going to get any smudging or flaking from that mascara. So really love that stuff. This primer is from Catrice and this is the under eye primer that I've been talking about, the camouflage under eye primer. And I really love how this plumps up my under eyes. I took the little stopper out of it so I could get every single last drop out of it. This does have a scent to it, you guys. And I can't put my finger on what the scent is, but it does have a scent to it. So again, if you are, you know, very sensitive to fragrance, you might want to stay away from it. I haven't researched what the fragrance is in it, but it hasn't given me any irritation so far. So I use this every single day. It plumps up those dry, wrinkly, really crepey look underneath my eyes, and then I can put my concealer on top of it and have a really great concealer day. So I really have been enjoying that one. That is my second or third one. I did have to get rid of this, however. This is from Mali. This is the Poreless Prep and Prime, something like that. This product is just too slick on my face. So even when I try to put it on, I feel like I just have too much slip there and it doesn't keep my foundation on. It doesn't really, I don't have a really good result with, you know, filling in the pores because I have really large pores. And so I just kind of got rid of this. I went almost to the end. And then I used up one of the smaller sizes of the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder. This is in Luminous Light. It's completely down to the little, there's nothing there. Anyway, I really like this one. I have several that I got in palettes that I'm going to be trying to work on, but I love these. And this lasted me a long, long time, like almost a year. And I was using it every day for my finishing powder, not setting powder where you would use a lot, but just a light dusting across the face. But Milani Prep Set and Glow is really close to this one too. So just so that you guys know that too, we can save some money there. And then two lip glosses that I used up this month. One was from Catrice. You can't get this one anymore, but I love this one. Had a tiny bit of shimmer in it and I really like this and really sad that it's gone, but I needed to use it up because it was getting older. And then this is one from Surratt Beauty and I actually almost used it up. I got down to here with it. And the reason that I'm getting rid of it is it just started to feel funky on my lips. It was like feeling really super thick and it was feeling like it was just going bad and I'd had it for long enough. So I got rid of that one. I probably won't go ahead and repurchase that one though. Okay, I think that was it. That was like the speed round of empties, but I wanted to make sure that I went through all of those with you guys. Hope that you do enjoy empties. Is there something in your closet or in your makeup bag or your skincare, hair care that you seem to go through like every month? I'd love to hear that if that's something that you really love. Those are things that we all buy and we repurchase over and over again. And that's what I feel like these videos are best for. Please give this video a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed, please consider subscribing. We would love to have you here as a part of our YouTube family. Thanks so much for spending a bit of your day with me today. Hope everybody is doing great and the sun is shining where you're at. Love you all so much. I'll see you all in my next video. Bye, guys.